So far, we have always or almost always worked with periods whose length is equal to 1 year. We reasoned that the payoffs happened at the end of each year, and computing present values then is a simple procedure. The discount rate used in this case is also known as the effective annual rate, and this actually works as a definition. That is, the effective annual rate is the discount rate which must be used when dealing with periods whose length is equal to 1 year. However, periods may obviously have a length shorter than 1 year. For example, they can be equal to 1 month, 1 quarter, or 6 months. In that case, if we have the effective annual rate, we cannot use it directly to discount such payoffs. The good news is that we can find it following a simple procedure whose underlying logic goes as follows. Suppose that we are in front of an investment whose payoffs occur in periods of 3 months. Suppose further that the effective annual rate is equal to 9%. How do we find the discount rate that we need to use in order to find the present value of payoffs that take place at the end of each quarter, that is, each 3 month period? In other words, how do we turn the effective annual rate into its equivalent quarterly discount rate? The way to think about this is to realize that we can also use the quarterly discount rate to move money across time over periods of 1 year. Since we should get the same result, regardless of what rate we use, this gives us an equality that we can then exploit to factor out the equivalent quarterly discount rate. More specifically, the discount rate that applies for a period of 3 months can be used to find the value of one monetary unit today, 3 months from now, by simply doing this multiplication, where R sub quarter denotes the equivalent quarterly discount rate. Now, what would be the value of such monetary unit 6 months from now? That is, 2 3-month periods away. We replicate the same arguments that we have used quite a lot by now, and we obtain the answer by doing this simple operation. Similarly, the value of one monetary unit 1 year from now is obtained by computing this value. Now, obviously, as we anticipated, this value must be equal to the one we obtain by using the effective annual rate. In other words, we must have that this equality holds. Now, to obtain the equivalent quarterly discount rate, all we have to do is to factor out its value by raising both sides of the equality to 1 over 4 in order to get rid of the exponent on the right-hand side, which gives this, and then we can easily conclude that the value after that we're after is equal to 0.0218 or equivalently 2.18%. Now, what if the problem presents us with a project whose payoffs take place at the end of each month instead? How do we obtain the equivalent monthly discount rate? That is, how do we turn the effective annual rate into its equivalent monthly discount rate? Once again, the way to think about this is to realize that we can also use the monthly discount rate to move money across time over periods of 1 year. Since we should get the same result regardless of what rate we use, this gives us an equality that we can then exploit to factor out the equivalent monthly discount rate. Specifically, the discount rate that applies over a period of 1 month can be used to find the value of one monetary unit today, 1 month from now, by simply doing this multiplication, where R sub month denotes the equivalent monthly discount rate. Now, what would be the value of such monetary unit 2 months from now, that is, 2 1-month periods away? We obtain the answer by doing this simple operation. Similarly, the value of one monetary unit 1 year from now is obtained by computing this value. Now, obviously, as we anticipated once again, this value must be equal to the one we obtain by using the effective annual rate. In other words, we must have that this equality holds. Now, to obtain the equivalent monthly discount rate, all we have to do is to factor out its value in a simple way, as we have done before. And when we do that and compute this, and we enter the numbers in our calculator, we find that 0.721% is the corresponding rate that we're after. Now, how do we turn the effective annual rate into its equivalent semiannual discount rate? Well, by now you probably got the picture. So it is easy to see that in general, this equality must be satisfied, where the equality reads 1 plus the EAR equals 1 plus the discount rate of the chosen shorter period, and where n, in this equality, is the number of those periods that there is in 1 year. So when we deal with months, n is 12, when we deal with quarters, n is 4, and when we look at 6 month periods, n is equal to 2. Now, the discount rate of the shorter period is thus obtained in a general way by solving the equality above. Now, note this is a two-way road. There will be situations in which we would like to obtain the effective annual rate that is implied by the discount rate that applies to a period shorter than 1 year. And actually, this is even simpler, since such EAR is obtained like this.